Hey friends, it's Brian and I'm working on my junky truck. I think this is episode 32. So today's project is the power steering pump. The other day I sprayed some gunk on here and wow, I had no idea there was anything written here or that was made out of metal. I thought that was a piece of black plastic, to be honest. Anyway, so we're gonna get this out of here. I need to go get some tools and get set up. Looks like that's a pivot bolt, and that is the adjustment bolt. And then looks like there's two bolts that hold it in. I've got a new hose here, and then I'm gonna replace the return hose. And hopefully this won't get too completely nasty. And I'm gonna put a rebolt pump, built pump in, and then I've got, I'm gonna take this pulley off and put it on the new one. So that is this morning's project. And then the next thing I'm going to do to this truck is swap this to a 3G alternator. I don't know if this alternator just doesn't charge. It's probably wiring issues, but I'm just going to replace it and move on. Because it's a 1G alternator with an external voltage regulator, and I want compact and simple and charging. So anyway, let's get started. All right, so let's begin the road to frustration. Not that one. So the upper one was 5/8 and the lower one is 9/16. Is not today's project. Air conditioning, power steering, alternator. All right. Probably should be today's project. You bolted something onto the vehicle without telling me you bolted something onto the vehicle. Well, that's loose. That's good that we found that. Sure. Dates from before the time when you worked on vehicles. At least be easy to remove. That's touch too. crack to hell too. All right, those are out. Where were we before we were so rudely interrupted? A little bit longer. There we go. That's what we needed, just a little bit more leverage. This is slow. Just, unfortunately, Ford didn't give a shit about access when they were designing this. It's unscrewing from the pump itself. It's not actually the hose, so we'll deal with that later. All right. Now, cleaning the gunk off of it before I put this wrench on. Well, nothing like confirmation that, yeah, you had a bad seal. Mm-hmm. So what I did is I got myself a furniture blanket to lay on so I can lay across the radiator without sharp shit sticking on me. Of course, there's a third one underneath. Okay. Well, it's a good thing I took all the belts off. There's always more than one way to reach the finish line. Thank you. hell is this threaded that far? Size hub this is. It is 1.13. All right, let me go do some research. All right, so we have another contestant courtesy of O'Reilly's. So they have a, yeah, that's actually a better puller. So let's see. That button fits properly, so this one might actually work. So this piece is called a button, and that's a collar. And we're going to withdraw this all the way up. Alright, so now I need a couple of adjustable wrenches. Let me go get those. Alright, so let's see where this gets us. Oh, those are the right noises. Those are still the right noises, yes. Might actually come apart. Needs just a little cleaning. This needs to go back to rock auto. Alright, be right back. Alright, so I've got one little unfinished piece of business. Had a stuck hose. This hose is getting replaced, so I'm not real worried about it. This needs to go back with the core. And that's probably why it was leaking, because that was super easy to remove. Let's take a look at this. Yeah, it's clearly it was around there. Bearings are okay, but the seal's what shot. You know, in theory, this should be rebuildable. It should be that and the seal, but it's been run dry so long, it just needs to be replaced. So I'm going to get this back to Rock Auto, and I'll do another video on installing the replacement.